It's happening as the CDC starts testing kids in grades K through 12. The goal, determine the COVID risk, the real one, to kids in school. And here's how it goes. According to the Missouri Department of Health, a student or teacher gets identified as a close contact to someone who tested positive for COVID, right? Then contact tracing begins. But those people are split into two different groups. In the first group, those who wore masks when they were exposed, they'll be allowed back in school. And in the second group, participants who will quarantine for 2 weeks, even if they had a mask on when they were exposed. Then they'll be able to compare. Both groups to be closely monitored and tested over a 30-day period. Then the CDC reports, it will publish the reports and we'll report on them. Widespread COVID testing for children is still lagging in most of our country. Parents say that it's really hard to find a site that doesn't have age restrictions, and waiting for the results keeps kids out of school for days, so it's very difficult. One new method could make it easier for children and cheaper for parents. Here's NBC's Villa Marks.
On Tuesday morning syllabus for Molly, Casey, and Julia Duval, a quick spit test. A sample of saliva left sealed in a bag.
Now I can do it in 2 minutes.
Their precious cargo carried into school and handed to teachers, alongside hundreds of others. Principal Molly King says this new kind of COVID-19 tests helped her school in Connecticut stay open safely.
When we found out about this option, not only was it cheaper, but far less invasive. And so those two things were really a winning combination to make us want to pursue this route.
Individual, vial, rack. And we do that 1,100 times.
Samples are scanned into small trays, then sent to a lab in New York. Each cluster of tubes, a classroom of kids tested in batches or pools to increase efficiency and reduce cost.
Aggressive routine testing is the only way that we will be able to reopen this country safely.
Prem Premsrit's company supplies dozens of schools in the Northeast with these same-day saliva tests, charging $15 per student per week.
Having a system where students could actually get tested and feel safe at school and create that sort of bubble for themselves was very, very important for me.
Colleges from Belgium to Illinois now testing student saliva, while in Britain a pilot program involves thousands of young children.
The saliva testing trial at schools here in the UK is funded by the government and costs parents nothing. But even if it did come with a price tag, keeping schools open safely might feel worth it for many families.
The FDA has approved one saliva-based system developed at Yale and shared so far for free with labs in 20 states, according to lead researcher Anne Wiley.
If at the state level, the federal level, if more people are seeing this and that they can see it as a reliable option or as a cheaper option and more...
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.